Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2, Enhanced Edition.
Where Minsk goes, blind. Evil stands aside.
Evil stands aside. What about commoners? They stand aside too? So we're in the bridge district and we're just still exploring. People in this house will really mess your stuff up. Just gotta say.
And welcome.
The thieves in this city have been getting mighty bold, if you ask me. Step out in the night and you're sure to be either robbed or murdered, aye? Aye. That's interesting. Look at that decoration there. I like that. Alright, so there's Rampa. We've talked to him. Stanet, we have not spoken to. Back here. A little farm here or something?
You're rather outlandish folk to be wandering round here.
I'm so nervous about this murder on the loose here. My feet here are all but curled up and hiding. Oh, that's a shame. I like this variation of the song, just gotta say. We heard it on the last episode or two. I approve. Have you ever traveled much out by the Umar Hills? Me husband says there be good mine in there, if they could ever makes it safe, that is. Yeah, mines are a problem in this area. Or the entire Sword Coast, pretty much. What's her name? Rose Bouquet? Bouquet? What's she doing with a name like Rose Bouquet? Who's that peasant? And Belle Dalemark.
Are you interested in some girls, Belle?
Hello there, handsome. What is it that Rose can do for you? Need a little rest and relaxation from your travels? Perhaps, though I am more interested in a little information right now. Information costs just like anything else. If you got the coin, I'll chit-chat as long as you like. 20 gold to your taste? We'll have a nice long talk. I'll pay you a little fee. Good. Talk all you want, then. I'll be your sympathetic ear. What's on baby's mind? Oh, did he mention her? The guards seem to think you saw something at a recent murder. That Aegisfield talks too much. I told him what I saw, which was nothing. A man in a hood. That's all I saw. Didn't know the poor sod that died. Wait, there was something. A smell. Besides the blood, I mean. I think it smelled girl bellies. Yeah, that's it. Girl bellies, or something like it. Girl berries. What are they used for? I can't recall. The guards didn't seem to think the information was important. They just laughed. I would probably recognize if I smelled it again. Talk to that merchant, Bell. He might know what smells like that. I'll see if I can choose between whatever he suggests. That'll help you, sweetie. Thank you. I'll be back as soon as I can. I'll be waiting. You bought your time. Alright, so I still... The time has not been used up. That's good to know. The courtesan Rose thought she remembered a smell at the murder scene. She said it was akin to girl bellies, but berries, but couldn't place it exactly. She directed me to Bell, a merchant, who she stated would know more about things that smelled like the berries, and offered to differentiate between the odors that Bell thought of. Well, this is interesting. Bell? Dalemark? I presume?
Have a look at my wares. I trust you'll find them all in satisfactory condition.
What can I do for you today? Seem a bit agitated. Anything you need? What do you have that smells like girl berries? Locally? Well, let me think. I know of three things with that smell. Girl berries are one, and the bark of the oak is similar, and solic berries, too. What would these things be used for locally? Well, I do a brisk business in girl berries. They are used in folk remedies, turned into tropical salves, or for intimate afflictions. Oak bark is used to make tannin, I believe. Natural curative agent for working with skins, but in use for centuries. There's a tanner, Rijik Heidsman, who has his shop near here. He might have some tannin. I'm not sure. Might be worth it to ask him. Salic berries are used in a local bakery for their signature mumbleberry pie. Very tasty, but they are closed now. It is the berries off-season. I have some of each if you wish, free of charge, because it's been a slow day. Was there anything else? I wanted to ask about this leather and where it might have come from. Let's see. Looks quite thick indeed. Very rare, but I have seen it before. This is elephant hide. Good for strong armor, but I rarely see it. Elephant hide? Where would someone get such leather? The obvious answer would be from an elephant. No, you're not in a joking mood, are you? Well, there are perhaps a few places one might get such hide. A tanner might see such hide on occasion, though it would be rare. Might be difficult to work with as well. Do not hear about such things all that often. If you want to know more, you might speak to an actual tanner. There's one not far from here, in the houses to the south. Rajik, if I remember his name. Well, he did say it like a minute ago. There's also a circus in town. I don't know if they have elephants, but the animal tamer would have certainly seen some in the past. Do you need anything else? You don't remember elephants, necessarily. No, I'm doubting myself. I know there was like a cougar or a leopard or something over there. No, that is all. Thank you. As you wish. I'll be here most days. The merchant, Bell, identified the strange piece of leather as elephant hide. Certainly difficult to find in this city, although Bell thought that a tanner might be able to get a hold of some. He also mentioned that a circus was in town. While he didn't know if they had elephants or not, the circus animal tamer might also be the one who could get such a hide. True, we should have back there.
Have a look at my wares. I trust you'll find them all in satisfactory condition.
What do you know about the murders in the area? Very little, aside from their rather gruesome nature. My sources say the flaying is far too precise to be the fault of a simple creature. I hope Inspector Agesfield finds the culprit soon. In the Bridge District, we've always been something of a family, and it pains me to see everyone full of paranoia now.
Well, you look like the sort who has more than two gold pieces to rub together.
I've heard a lot about the war between the thieves' guilds in the city. Do you know anything about that? Only thieves could have a war in plain sight without leaving a trail of bodies, huh? But if you know about the war, you probably know about who's involved. You got the Shadow Thieves on one hand and a new upstart guild on the other. The upstarts have one advantage. Nobody knows anything about them. You can't even approach them. They approach you, their recruiters appearing out of nowhere. I hear the upstarts have powerful dark magic, too. And it makes sense, too. What else could make the Shadow Thieves pause for more than a second? Simple thief rivals would be squashed flat. Not to discount the Shadow Thieves, though. They've got power enough in Athcatla to take on anyone, even the cowled wizards. I'll just wait this out. Alright, let's see what we got. Alright, we got Solic Berries. These are one of the two types of berries that you have obtained from Bell Dalemark. Rose Bouquet has said that the berries smell something like a man who may be the murderer that stalks the Bridge District. She would like to smell them again, to be sure. Okay. And, yeah, there's the actual girl berries. That's the exact same text there. And oak bark. This is a wide piece of oak bark. Bell Dalemark has mentioned that oak bark is used to make tannin, a necessary ingredient in the tanning of animal hides. And what does he sell?
Calamshites, Teferians, Warandavians, they all make their way here eventually to arm, they do.
Okay. Oh, he has the bullets plus one. We don't really have that much. It's 406 for 40 of them. Okay. She doesn't need any, because this one doesn't require bullets. These are regulars. I'm just gonna go like this. These are both regular. Yeah, I'm being choosy about this right now. Ooh. That looks like a dangerous person there. CO chair. Oh, yeah, let's. Chair? Maybe something like that.
Helping others and doing good things.
Back again? This has to be the weirdest question I've ever asked a customer, but do you have what you wanted me to smell? Yes, I do. He gave me 3 things for you to sample. Alright then, I'll have a look. Let me have those. Oh. I've just remembered why I knew it smelled like Guril berries. And that's not what the man smelled like. Oh, no wonder the guards were laughing. Never mind. Next. Salic berries. Mumbleberry pie, right? That's not the smell, though. Good thing, too. I'd hate to think of the murders every time I smell the pie. Next. That's the one. This tree bark stuff? It was stronger smelling on him, though. This is the same, but it's faint. What would make him smell like this? It's oak bark. It's used to make tannin for making leather. So he might have worked with leather? Odd. Well, I hope that helped. You got what you wanted. Off with you now. Perhaps. No. Goodbye. The courtesan rose tested the 3 samples Belle gave me and identified the oak bark as the one that the murderer smelled of, only much stronger. The bark is used to make tannin, so it is likely that the murderer worked with leather in some way. Okay. Move along, dearie. I have no time for simple chit-chat. Maybe we can talk when you have something important to say. Hey, these murders need to be solved.
Topical day to you.
Have you been to either 5 Flagons? 'Tis a grand place to drink, and I hears that the playhouse in the basement is worth the price to get in. The 5 Flagons. Alright, I'll keep that in mind. Oh, we're gonna talk to this person, right? Can I take that? Alright, I'm not gonna take this one though. There's somebody standing there. CO Char, whatever.
Greetings, good customer. A pearl to you.
Hello to you, my lord. I have a small amount of goods that I sell out of my cart here, some of which you might be interested in. It's a very roguish looking person though. It's not stolen merchandise, is it? Not at all. I assure you that my goods are quite legitimate, unlike many other things in the area of the docks, more than likely. What do you know about the murders in the area? Not much, I'm afraid. It is a terrible thing, however, and it makes me frightened to even step out of doors at night. The guards have not been able to do much about it, it seems. Alright, let me see what kind of stock you have then. As you wish. Berries. Heals 1 hit point. Created by the good berry spell, these simple-looking blueberries will heal 1 point of damage for each handful of berries eaten. It's good for topping off, I guess, but would not anywhere near beat a potion of healing, for example. That was a different kind of gem bag. This small bag is ideally suited for holding gems, indeed. She's screaming, William. By the way, I forgot. To redistribute our healing potions, such as they are. Potions. All right. We need more healing potions soon. We don't have a whole lot of money.
I don't like cities much. They're built on the backs of the unfortunate.
Greetings, good customer. A pearl to you.
Buy scrolls. Oh, much better. Nice. Those are some good gems. All right, now we can buy some healing potions. I have a few of these, so these we can use to cure poison. Yeah.
Anything you need, I can likely provide, I assure you.
Yeah, I assure you. Alright, let's see if this guy has any. I don't think he has healing potions. Let me just look. I wasn't looking for them.
You'll find no better prices in Arm. I guarantee it.
He has no potions here, just a potion of strength. Okay. Get your hands off me. Another guy sitting in the background. Alright, so we've got two doors to check out here. Hopefully I don't go in and immediately get attacked by somebody. Oh, is this the Five Flagons? Talia Thunderburp. That's quite a name.
Go
jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Speak up.
He was speaking up. They don't have enough guards around this part of the city. Just ain't safe. Am I stealing tips? I think I just stole someone's tip. No, I'm still doing it. Well, someone left their necklace. Lord Sturk. Well, there's a lot of people in here with interesting names. Jerry Jamtoes? You think I can't fight monsters, do you? Just because I'm short? Well, I can run through an orc's legs better than anybody. Hrothgar Firehammer. How'd I know I was gonna say that? Hey now, you weren't eyeing me grog, were you? You can't have it. It's my grog.
Yes?
I'd be scared to go out into the streets at night. Me husband says there'd be ghouls on the loose to eat your flesh. Lord Sturk.
My time is quick, so be brief, commoner.
You haven't seen my insignet ring, have you? It's a family heirloom. It must have fallen off my finger, I suppose. Yoshimo, yelling from across the room. Perhaps you should have been more careful about wearing such a thing to this part of the city. Have you tried retracing your steps?
Is it important, peasant?
It is, peasant. Ah, if it isn't the sweet Nalia d'Aranis. It's so good to see you within the city, my dear. Is Delcia with you? I'd so love to talk with her. Oh, Nalia, right. I recall Auntie mentioning that when last you two met. You spilled tea on her dress on purpose, and I find your asking after her now rather insulting. Excuse me. Okay, and here's Belle. Try anything with me, and you might live to regret it. Alright, watch it, Minsk. Oh, there's stairs down over here. Oh, who's that? Oh, there's Thalia. Thalia Thunderburp.
Oh, it's a fine day for meeting new friends.
Careful, big man. I am a halfling serving lass, not a footstool. Minsk says, I am sorry, little halfling. They get mad if we open this. They get mad if I take this. So far, so good. Alright, so there's stairs up and there's stairs down over there. Uda the cook.
You have nothing better to do.
You get out of the kitchen or Uda will pull you over knee and be spanking your bare buttocks. Out! Oh my. She's gonna spank you. She's gonna spank you, Minsk. Minsk might be intrigued at that. Alright, let's go upstairs first before we go downstairs. Anyone else? Oh, we haven't talked to... Oh! I guess that's related. There might be a husband and wife team. Samuel Thunderburp? Is this the Five Flagons?
Hello, me good smiling friends.
It is.
Here at the Five Flagons, you'll find a cheery smile in every beverage in Faerûn available for your appreciation.
You have every type of drink available? I hardly believe that.
It's as true, my friend. I may not keep it all on the shelf. Not much call for termish beer, for instance. But I bet the fur in my feet I have it all in the cellar.
Well, I'll be going. I want to ask him the other questions.
Well, do come back sometime. Nothing like a good beverage, some entertainment, and quality halfling service to put a grin on your face.
I have a beverage of every flavor available for your perusal at the Five Flagons, you sin dainty item.
What do you know about the murders in this area?
'Tis a terrible thing. Bad for business, too, since no one can walk at night. Strike me, though, those poor innocents are more important than my little tavern.
There's a theater downstairs if you like, but don't forget a mug of spiced wine before you go.
Perhaps you can tell me about the war between the thieves' guilds I've been hearing about.
I don't pay much attention to myself. If the thieves are fighting amongst themselves, it'd probably be better for everyone if they finished the job.
Alright, we have available.
But of course, take a look at the shelves. We have Tetherian Brandy, Symbian Mead, Theskin Dark Ale, even a bit of Dwarven Grog, if that tickles your fancy. And if you haven't already, do take a look at the theater established downstairs. I'm told the plays are a marvel. Ooh, but I prattle. Let me get you a menu.
You only have 5 things here. I guess everything else is downstairs, like you said. How about some Westgate wine? Not enough for any rumors and stuff. Alright, let's check upstairs.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
This one's empty.
I am ready, I think. I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
Oh, another scroll of Identify, sweet. Forgot. A paltry 9 gold. I like the bedspreads, though.
You point, I punch. Stand back for justice!
Ah, someone in this one. A sleeping woman? Hello. Hmm? This district used to be quite safe and affluent. Things have just gone downhill, I suppose. Sorry to intrude. Thought it was our room.
Yeah. Faster than chick, take a fast pause.
Saucy battle bow! Run, bow, run!
It's like a mini banquet hall or something. Yo, traffic jam.
What do you need? Fleet of foot and all that.
Let him in. All that for nothing. Alright, we can't close the door again, that's fine.
Minsk and Boost, make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
What's this? Covered wagons? These canvas wagons have been brought inside and converted to decoration. How weird. Let's talk to Urseus.
You said something?
You're blocking my view. Why don't you go and see the play downstairs? They're still doing one, I think. Blocking his view. Okay. Can we... I don't think we can go in them. It's just a question mark. Can we walk through this? It looks like... Oh. I thought it was a wall at first? Okay. Some kind of common area?
You require my counsel, yes?
No, your thieving abilities.
Yoshimo is willing.
Okay.
Every hamster butt kicking, for goodness!
Every hamster butt kicking.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Yeah, we're gathering.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Ah, let's see this theater.
Pleasure to meet you.
A fair eve to you, sir. The troop of players is just beginning its next performance. If you wish to partake, we ask that you donate 5 gold for a ticket, but it is not required. Would you like to purchase a ticket then, sir? What sort of play is this? It is a most dramatic play put on by the fine members of the Sigil Troop. 'Tis better to see than to be described. Would you like the ticket then, mehap? Certainly. Here's your 5 gold. I notice that we don't have an option to get it without paying, although she told us there was an option. Most gracious of you, ma'am. You may enter the theater as you wish. Just show your ticket to yon ushers, please. I don't actually have a ticket, though. Okay.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
I hope you both enjoy the play then, sir. Fall of the House of Usher.
Yes?
Thank you, sir. Go on inside. Hope you enjoy the play.
Yes?
Has abandoned thee, sweet Lunesia. You have only one option left. Turnest thou to me, and let us be wed at last.
No, Kirinaldo, I cannot. Oh, Rodrigo, Rodrigo, my fair love, where hast thou gone?
Rodrigo?
Here I am, my, sweetums.
Rodrigo! Rodrigo! It is thee at long last! But where have...
I've been, across the sea, my fair one. Yes, that's it. Across the sea, and,
Say, that's not the actor they had last time.
And perhaps on the new lands, my lord?
Yes, that's it. On the new lands. Yes,
Where's the actor that was here last time?
Oof.
This is terrible! Awful!
But is it Rodrigo? No, no. How can this be?
Well, you should be so, confused.
It is confused, right?
It is baffled! Baffled!
Baffled, yes. Well, you should look so baffled, my lord. Kirinaldo. 'Twas you who...
Now you sound like an owl.
Terrible. Get him off the stage.
Who, which that, in the way...
Arranged for me to be shipped across the sea.
What's that?
Yes, you are correct, Rodrigo. 'Twas I that arranged for thy trip across the great ocean. 'Twas, truly fiendish of me. But how did thy ever come to return so quickly?
He has no idea.
I forget. I'm just the understudy.
Please, Bane, I refuse to watch this.
I agree. Boo! Boo!
Boo! Boo, that's awful. Hannibal!
Boo, I say. Boo.
Oh, dear.
Oh wait, there. Is Mintz gonna think they're talking to his hamster?
I am sorry, good folk of the audience. As you can see, things are not quite right with our troop due to circumstances beyond our control.
What is this? Mintz says. Minsk and Boo were just getting into this wonderful story when it was sadly interrupted. A work of mastery this is.
I beg of you, good people, come back another day when we have restored matters. We shall prove to you then that the Sigil troop is worthy of your attention and coin. And we shall do so for free, of course.
In effect, you're already doing it for free. You were like just doing a 5 gold donation thing.
And one final odd request, good folk. If you or another knows of those who are skilled in the arts of sword and adventure, do send them to speak to me. It is a matter of utmost urgency.
Did you hear that, Minsk?
Tell them to come and speak to I, Raelis Shy. Until then, I apologize again and bid you a fair evening.
Raelis Shy. Sounds familiar, though. Raelis Shy asks for aid. It seems the playhouse beneath the Five Flagons is in need of some adventurers. A woman by the name of Raelis Shy has asked for any interested to go backstage and speak to her about the matter. I don't think these people have anything to say about the play. Probably just random stuff to say. They won't talk. Alright. We're gonna go talk to Raelis Shy next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.